So friends, in this video I will discuss about a question, that is, I remember the DNA has A, T, C and G, but who decides which ones go where? How does the sequence get set and what happens if something goes out of order? What's a memory device I can use on an upcoming test? Welcome to my YouTube channel. So this video is going to be very informative. So please watch this video till the end. So let's start this video. So firstly, I will discuss about what is DNA. DNA is a hair dietary material in the humans and nearly all other organisms. It is a complex molecule that contains the genetic instructions for the development, functioning, growth and reproduction of all non-life. DNA is a long polymer that takes the shape of the double helix, which looks like a twisted ladder. The next I will discuss about how the DNA sequence is set. The primary way the sequence is set is by using an existing strand as a template. The first one is the template strand inheritance, and the second one is the base pairing rules, that means the decider. Let's discuss the first one, that is the template strand inheritance. The fundamental order of your DNA bases ATCG is determined by the DNA sequence inherited from your parents. When a cell divides, the existing DNA double helix unwinds and each single strand acts as a template for building a new complementary strand. The second one is the base pairing rules, that is the decider. The rule for which a new base goes where is strictly enforced by complementary base pairing. A always pairs with T and G always pairs with C. During the DNA replication, the enzyme's DNA polymers moves along the template strand and only allows the correct complementary base to be inserted into a new growing strand. This mechanism ensures the daughter DNA molecule is an exact copy of the original. Now I will discuss about what happens if the sequence is out of the order. If the sequence of bases gets out of the order, it results in a mutation. While cells have sophisticated DNA repair mechanisms to fix most errors, those that persist can have consequences ranging from silent to catastrophic. So there are three types. Let's discuss the first one, that is a silent mutation. If a change occurs but it doesn't alter the final protein product, because multiple DNA codes can specify the same amino acid, it is called a silent mutation and often has no effect on organism. The second one is a harmful mutation. A change in a single base pair is called a point mutation. If this change alters the structure or a function of the critical protein, it can lead to a disease. The example is a single point mutation in a gene for a hemoglobin is what causes sickle cell disease. The third one is a beneficial mutation evolution. Rarely, an out-of-the-order sequence can result in a change that gives the organism an advantage. These beneficial mutations are the raw material for evaluation. Now, let's discuss the memory device for base pairing. To remember the complementary base pairs for your test, use a simple mnemonic device. A pairs with T and G pairs with C. So friends, in this video, I discussed about the DNA. I hope you have gained a very good information from this video. So finally, in the end, if you found this video helpful, so please like the video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, because in my channel, the videos of education related contents are always coming. Thank you.